What's up, everybody? This is Jay, and this video is about the demise of the goon, Franken Grimm. Now, we know Grimm, Slim Grimm. He was Tommy's right-hand man. Before we get into it, if you enjoy my videos and you like to stay up to date with TV shows like Power, please hit that like button. I'm trying to get 200 likes. And if you want to enjoy these videos and don't want to miss one, please subscribe and hit that bell so you get notified of all my videos. Let's get into it. Now, Tommy, he wasn't always the nicest to his right-hand man, Grimm, and he wasn't always that appreciative. But everybody that watched the show knows that Grimm was the pillar that held Tommy up. And just recently, when Tommy was trying to get them to work to get Tariq back, you got Urkel and Jerkel. They was upset, and Grimm, he was upset, but he didn't say nothing. And when they told him, hey, it's for the kid, okay? They got Tariq. They got him kidnapped, okay? We got to get the money, all right? And he said, it's for the kid, man. And Urkel and Jerkel was pissed because they was trying to negotiate with Tommy. I'll do it. And he was looking like a little half dead anyway, and walking dead, zombie apocalypse, head on swole, lips looking like pink booty meat. But nevertheless, he was there for Tommy. Tommy was white, and he was the, you know, dark side of the moon. And so Urkel and Jerkel was pissed at him. They tried to pull him to the side, but he wasn't trying to hear it. He was loyal to Tommy to a fault. Even when Keisha was carrying the bags, Tommy like, hey, what you doing over there? Go and help the lady. You can't let the lady struggle. You go and help her. And even though that was Tommy woman, Tommy should have helped her. But nevertheless, Grimm, being the loyal soldier that he was, I got it. Hey, hold on. Let me help you. I can help. Let me help you. Let me get the bag. And so he ran over there grabbing the bag while Keisha dragging Munch Wagon from the rear. He didn't mind going to help. And when he was talking with Urkel and Jerkel, and they was all questioning, why is he always up under Tommy? How they gonna get new supply? What's Tommy gonna do?
Hey, Tommy's got a plan, man. Okay, he's gonna figure it out. I don't know what he's gonna do, but he's gonna get something going, okay?
And so they was just looking like, man, this dude loved Tommy, man. And really, I thought that if anybody would have killed him, it would have been Jerkel, aka 2-Bit. And even when he went and brought that weight back,
hey man, Zeke, he got 2 stars on Yelp. His product is no good, man. Hey, let me get a snack, Tommy. Hey, by the way, are these sugar free? I'm trying to lose weight. Are these sugar free?
And Tommy, he don't know where, he don't understand that this dude got a eating weight problem. His weight problem, he can't wait to eat. And Tommy said, hey, I told you, stop going in my damn refrigerator eating my snacks. Come on, man. Let's go. We got to handle this. Come on, Grimm. And so the man that he chose to help when they wanted to grab little Luigi was Grimm. And Luigi walked into him, and they bumped him, knocked him up. Tommy choked him out. They balled him up, threw him in the back seat like a bag of groceries. And he was smiling.
We got him, Tommy. We got him.
And when he was talking with Urkel and Jerkel, it seemed that whenever it was a problem, he always had Tommy's back. And even when that product came up missing, he was saying,
how the product come up missing, man? Who was over here? I didn't do it. I wasn't here.
And Keisha, she came in trying to get all over 2-Bit or whatever, talking about, yeah, okay, who found it? I don't know. That's a whole nother video about why she come all hard all of a sudden about to check these gangsters or whatever. But maybe she felt secure because she know that Grimm was there to back her up. If anything would have went left, he wouldn't have let nothing happen to her. And I'm pretty sure she knew that. And that's why she probably felt emboldened to talk to 2-Bit the way that she did. Yeah, he grabbed her or whatever, but she probably felt secure knowing that between Tommy and Grimm, nothing would have happened to her. And when his nose was inflamed with anger on both sides of the nostrils, she was able to still talk her smack because she know Grimm was gonna be there and Tommy. But anyway, Grimm, once she left, he said, "What you do that for, man? Why you grab her? Why you do that? Oh no, wait, Keisha, don't tell Tommy. Don't do that, man. Why you do that, man? What you mean, all of us? We in trouble. I'm gonna be put on punishment, man. Why you do that?" And so he sounded a little, pissed. He was afraid of Tommy. But nevertheless, Tommy wouldn't have messed with him, because Tommy know that he a loyal soldier. And he was pretty much the most loyal soldier Tommy ever had. He would have never betrayed Tommy. Tommy been with him, and he been with Tommy for, a couple seasons now. And, two bit, he always had his little anger issues, like he was ready to overthrow Tommy or, whatever the case, to get to number two spot. When they grabbed Dre and threw him in the trunk like old laundry, they brought him back to the base or whatever. And when they opened it up to show Tommy, they was going to end up killing Dre right then and there. And Dre really kind of owed his life to, the Grimace, Frankengrim, because he said, "Let's kill him right here." And Grimm said, "Wait a minute, Tommy. Isn't the enemy of the enemy the friend? Wait a minute. Isn't the enemy of our enemy our friend? Is that how it go? Fool me once, shame on you. You fool me twice, you can't fool me again. That's how it go, right, Tommy? Anyway, we should let him go. What you think? Why don't we work something out?" And even though they didn't really listen to him, they still ended up keeping him and taking him away. He saved Dre from being eliminated right then and there. And so Dre kind of owed him and didn't deserve to kill him the way that he did. They should have just knocked him out. We seen Ghost knock him out with one hit when Ghost and Kanan robbed Tommy's dope spot. Dre, he knew that his time was coming. He could smell that his days was numbered and that he was pretty much in trouble. And he was starting to, smell what the gangsters was cooking, and he devised a plan. So once he heard that they say that they was leaving, he knew that Grimm was the big softy out of the three. And so, for some reason, they decided to leave Grimm alone.
"I want him. I got him. I take care of him. Okay."
And so, once they left, they were still talking or whatever. And like you said, Dre, he knew they were gone. He heard them talking about their plans or whatever. And so, he decided to make noise to get Grimm's attention. He know Grimm was a little slow. And so, he opened up the little blinds or whatever, took off the little mask that they had over him, the blindfold or whatever, and then he took the little tape off of Dre's mouth. They didn't want to cover up the nose and mouth at the same time. He would have had to breathe through that double barrel snot gun. He might have suffocated. And so once they removed it, he said, "Hey man, look, I know y'all gonna kill me. Just let me hear my daughter's voice one more time, man. Just please, man. Let me hear it, man. I know it is what it is." And of course, Grimm, he gonna fall for it. And he ended up being the only one that would have worked for, because Urkel and Jerkel wouldn't have given a damn. And Dre knew that. And so he ended up getting his hands free while he was doing all that talking. And Grimm say, "Look, man, be quiet. They hear you, man. They hear you. Be quiet." And so he said, "Look, what's the number? Okay, what's the number? I call it for you. What's the number?" And so he was about to call the number for him, not realizing, like an idiot, that he got the key to Dre's escape right in front of him, which was his gun tucked real easy and perfect for Dre to just take and shoot him with. I don't know why he didn't have it behind his back at least, but that's the writing of Power Season 6. Nevertheless, Dre, he smelled the opportunity. And so while he was pretending to give him the number or whatever the case, as soon as Grimm built bent that head over, He knew that he had the leverage, and so he went and grabbed Grimm's gun, and next thing you know, he shot him in the head. Grimm didn't even know what hit him. Next thing you know, he was having a convertible, more like convertible Grimm, and it was all a wrap. Head splattered all on the wall, brain matter, and headquarters was destroyed. The last of the Milk Dud brothers has been eliminated. Donovan, and we had Terry eliminated last season. The only one left is the White Chocolate, aka Dr. Evil, aka Bruce Willis, Kojak. That's all that's left, because Grimm, he was the biggest and the slowest, and now he's dead. And Dre, man, he got no love for nobody. He just a one man on a mission without no support, no love, nothing. And all he got is supposedly love for his daughter, even though he killed the man right in front of his daughter, which was crazy. I think it was messed up that Grimm ended up dying the way he did, especially while he was trying to help. He really didn't have the heart for this game. He was too nice of a guy. We done seen him get beat up too many times to be so big. And it's just sad that he ended up with somebody like Tommy and not with somebody like Ghost, who would have took care of him, had him in a suit. Eventually, he would have got out the game and making more money. But being with Tommy, he was bound to be dead or in jail eventually, because Tommy is reckless, and Tommy would have never really took care of him the way he needed to be taken care of. Vote right here. Y'all tell me what you think. Should he stay with Tommy, or should he have gotten with somebody like Ghost? Or was he too soft for the game and should have never got in the game to begin with? Please check out jmorereviews.com for more great content. I'm also going to be putting a forum for everybody to chat about Power. Also, I want to thank everybody that support me as part of my Patreon family. I hope you enjoy all my content as always. And last but not least,